It's the ocean next door, but we don't know enough about what's below the surface.
What I'm going to show you here, Ken, is a deep sea red crab. And it's just to give you an idea of how big and beautiful the life of the deep sea is out there in the Atlantic.
The iAtlantic team has more than 30 partners. They'll be using technology like this, robotic sea gliders, to map ocean life from the Arctic to South America.
We're starting to work with colleagues who have measurement systems between South Africa and Brazil and Argentina. We're doing that type of measurement in the North Atlantic, combining these biogeochemistry measurements with our big physics arrays to try and understand the problem of oxygen in the oceans.
Oceanic oxygen levels are falling, and that's just one of the Atlantic's problems.
90% of the global warming the planet's experienced has been taken up by the oceans, and they're getting hotter. They're also becoming more acidic, because when you put CO2, carbon dioxide, in the atmosphere, 25% of that has dissolved in the sea, and they're running out of breath. The oxygen in seawater is diminishing really quickly as it gets warmer.
The project will be looking at life from plankton to humpback whales in 12 key areas. This is one example of the enormous biodiversity of the Atlantic Ocean. People tend to think of coral as being stuff like this that grows in the Pacific, but this coral grows not too far off the Scottish coast. This coral reef off the Western Isles has been mapped using sonar and 3D modelling, just two of the techniques the project will be sharing on both sides of the equator.
These reefs are very, very important because they provide a home for many animals, which can shelter there, they can feed there, they can reproduce there, and some of them are very economically important for us because they might end up on our plate, like, for example, cod.
The project will involve specialists in biology, physics, artificial intelligence and more, all trying to find out which areas are most under threat and which could be safe havens. The iAtlantic project has 4 years to acquire an enormous amount of information. It underlines how little we know about what's going on down there, and also how little time we have to find out. Kenneth MacDonald, Reporting Scotland.